Welcome back to Modern Homestead Alaska. It is Tuesday. We are headed to the eye doctor for Caleb, but when we get home, we will see what we can get done for the Every Bit Counts challenge. Join us. Welcome to our vlog. We are the Milnes family. We started building a modern homestead outside of Wasilla, Alaska in the summer of 2021. That's my husband, Aaron. I am Jessica, a stay-at-home wife and mom. Our second son, Caleb, lives here with us, along with our daughter, Cody Ann, and the youngest of our family, Wyatt. We brought our two dogs, Tipper and Daisy, and got a new addition, the Alaska dog, Roberto. Hey, so Caleb's appointment is going to be at least 2 hours, and so I'm at a Costco I've never taken you to. We're not going to do a great big Costco haul. I'm going to show you everything, but I am going to go in here and see if there's anything that I could prep. Just so you know, the reason I don't, if you can see that, I'm at this lower Costco, but there is one way on the north side, and that's the road that we come into Anchorage in. But Caleb's doctor is only maybe 2 miles from this Costco, so I thought we would stop by, see if there's anything that we need to get. Anything we can add to our storage. This will not be some ridiculous thousands of dollars. At the most, $100-$200 is all I would spend today. So let's take a look though. They're like set up totally opposite of the Costco that I go to, which is weird when you walk in and everything's on the opposite side. Oh, those are pretty though. These are really beautiful Christmas fall colors. Nice, 4-pack for 20. So Caleb and I were talking on the way here to Anchorage that we're gonna get these smaller totes and we are going to do, we are gonna do emergency kits in both Caleb and Cody's cars. And they have these winter blankets. I have a different brand that I carry in my truck, but these will fit perfectly in the little totes that'll go in both of their cars, and they're $26.99. They're this kind of a lightweight, but it's a wonderful for an emergency blanket. So I'm gonna get one for both Caleb and one for Cody's cars. Okay, they do have these, so actually, $14.99 for 3 flashlights. We each have these in our packs already, but I'm going to go ahead and put these in the emergency kits for the kids. These nice and clean disinfecting wipes, $12.89. These will be perfect in their kit. We're gonna grab these so that I can roll up the breakfast burritos for Wyatt. I was hoping they'd be on sale. They're not. Okay, let's add this for $8.79 to our stock, because if we were without water, our water would be really stale tasting. That might help. Okay, I have space for one more bath tissue at the house. So because they have so much, I'm gonna go ahead and be fully set. We just used all of this up on the banana bread, so I'm gonna go ahead and grab some of that because we do love our sour cream. And then I'll grab milk while I'm here. It's a lot cheaper than Three Bears or anywhere else. So $9.38 for 2 gallons of milk. And then because we eat so much of it, regardless of the price, $12.79. for 5 dozen eggs. We've already gone through the ones we bought last week. We don't have these at the Costco I go to, so $23.79 are these chocolate covered espresso beans. These are $31 at Three Bears. I wish I would have known. All right, that's it. We're gonna check out. Caleb just called me. He's done at the eye doctor, and I'm gonna go get him picked up. While I get ready, I'm gonna go get Caleb. I only spent, and I say only because of some of the things I got are expensive, $161 at Costco today. But that might be something that you need to kind of look into. We have emergency kits for every, they're in our fishing thing, like all the time Aaron and I buy like first aid kits. And then I build a little box, one of those black and yellow boxes for each one of the cars. It's got everything like peanut butter, some water bottles, they freeze during the winter, but there's like a metal camp stove that's like this big and it has a gas thing. And then it has a metal cup to where if the kids were actually stranded someplace, they needed to melt snow, they needed to melt the water bottle, you know, anything like that. Peanut butter, I might have already mentioned, a first aid kit, some sanitizing wipes, all of those things are kept in our vehicle, and then every vehicle gets a shovel and something like sand or kitty litter or whatever to get them out of situations. We always carry extra coats in our vehicles. We learned all of this in Colorado because I had been stranded for a while and had to have Aaron come and get us, my car, the whole nine yards, and the kids were little. And so we keep all of those things, extra hats and gloves. They don't have to be the most expensive, top of the line, but as you are preparing for winter, if you do get heavy winters like we get, build an emergency kit for your kid's car, an ability to start some fire, keep themselves warm. And those blankets, believe it or not, I hiked Havasu Falls and it was snowing on us and you're not allowed any fire or whatever up there, and I had a blanket very similar that I wrapped around me inside of our sleeping bags, and it kept me so warm. And I carry it, mine is red, different brand, my mom got it for me as a birthday present when I had borrowed hers. She loved it so much she went and got me one. So I wrap my legs and stuff in my truck in it, like it is used constantly during winter because Aaron and I don't like everything at the same temperature. So when I'm cold, I take that blanket everywhere, football games, whole nine yards. So it's great to have that in the car. They can just whip it out whenever they want. It doesn't necessarily have to be for an emergency. If they're just someplace and they're cold or whatever, keeps them from getting sick, the whole nine yards. So build an emergency kit for yourself and your kids' cars, no matter where you live, that you know I have at least first aid, something. A lot of their friends have like diabetes or whatever, so having some things on hand for an emergency is amazing. So that's my tidbit of mom advice to everyone.
Chill, no recording.
All right, what did the eye doctor say?
100% good.
No more patch?
No, I don't even want to wear it.
But you do have to wear sunglasses all day. They dilated it? Let me see your eye. Oh, they dilated both of them.
Yeah, I can't.
Pop those on right now.
I can't even see, bro.
You do not want to be in the sun.
I can't even read mine.
So, for real though, what all did he say?
He literally looked at them for 30 seconds and then was like, oh, you're good to go, man.
You're good to go. So it wasn't some long 2-hour appointment. No scratch, nothing to the eye. Awesome. That is amazing. Did he tell you won the lottery again?
Yeah, the same doctor who did my surgery.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Was he amazed?
Yeah. He thought I was going to lose my eye.
Really?
He said he was prepared to open my eye and just see it oozing out in surgery, but it didn't.
It didn't. Nice. Thank God, right?
Yeah.
It's crazy. Wildest story we've told so far in Alaska.
Oh, yeah.
I'm so happy for you.
Oh, yeah.
All right, I put on one of my least favorite aprons. It's not that it's not pretty, it's the texture and material, but because I'm gonna be working with wax here, I'm totally cool with it. I did get home, I'm ready to start melting the wax. I don't know how long that's gonna take. And so I thought I would get you guys going on the wax for the cheese. If anyone new around here, hello, we're waxing cheese. So I've got this brand new tiny little crock pot, which I think is gonna be great. I'm gonna show it to you and explain to you why I think it's gonna be great. Okay, so when dipping the cheeses in, if you had it in a great big round crock pot or bowl, then you have a lot of surface area, kind of like when you dip chocolate. But to dip it in this really narrow, small crock pot, I think that the cheese wax is going to melt really well. And then I think it'll be easier to dip it. So we're using less wax and in a smaller environment. So here is the wax. I have three red, one clear if I decide to do clear. And let me just tell you, these are made in the USA, but they come with absolutely zero instructions. But don't you worry, I watched a bunch of YouTube videos on this, so never fear. Okay, so we're gonna open the wax. Seems like, almost like saran wrap around it. Okay, yeah, real thin. Just so you know, it's raining now. And so my dogs are playing inside, so if you hear them, I'm really sorry about that. Okay, let me get you set up. Hang on.
You'll be right. Right by the stickiness of this, I do not want this in one of my pans. So I'm just gonna kinda, I've seen people grate it, but also just slice it like this. So we're just gonna slice our cheese wax, slice away. Tipper. All right, come on over. While the wax is melting, I thought I would get some pizza crust started. This is my favorite pizza crust. I know I've shown it before. But going into the month of September, what I want as one of my personal goals, we'll continue to live our life, anything we build, whatever we do, we'll share with you guys. But what I want is to do some easier things that are in the freezer ready to go. Well, I like to make homemade pizza, so much cheaper than ordering it out. And when I make these pizza crusts, I wrap them with saran wrap and I get them in the freezer, they defrost really, really quickly. I make the sauce just with a can of tomatoes and some spices just in the food processor or the NutriNinja or whatever it is, and then some cheese, and then you can do whatever toppings that you want. But because we have so much cheese being stored, we need to be making our own pizzas. So we're gonna eat this tonight. However, I want to do a triple amount of pizza crust. We're going to attempt to do a triple amount in this mixer. Now, I'm told it will hold it, but we're about to find out. So to do so, I have 3 cups of milk that I'm gonna get going here. We want it warm. And then I have some water. I just want the water heated up to where I can hold my finger in it, but it's really, really warm to the touch. I'll get that in here and going with the yeast. I'll bring you back once we have that ready. While this is going, as we're approaching the end of this challenge, I have gotten a lot of questions from new viewers, and a lot of those questions will take more than I can type out with the amount of messages that I'm getting or comments that I'm responding to. So we are going to do a Q&A. If you've been around a long time and have a question about something, or you're new here and you have questions, you're allowed to ask any question you want to ask. And if it borderlines on a privacy issue or something like that that we don't want to answer, we won't answer it. However, we're willing to open up and share our life to an extent, right? Because we still have teen children and a marriage and a life and family and those sort of things that are important to us, that we do reserve some of our privacy. But anything that we show on our channel or that we talk about on our channel, we are happy to clarify. Yes, we did start building this house. It was just that framed box that you see in the intro. There is no electrical, no plumbing. We put this kitchen wall in, we changed some things around, so on. We bought that. Do you want to know what got us here, how we got here, why Alaska, what price per square foot you're looking at to build a home like this? What are some of the things we did? I get a lot of questions about my wood stove, so on. I am willing to answer your questions, and I may have to pull Aaron or even some of the kids in depending what those questions are. So there will be a post under my community link, and if you will write your questions, we will try and answer them when this month challenge is over. So in September, we will answer your questions. Leave them in the comment sections of the post. Okay, so this is warm enough. I can still hold my finger in it. I'm gonna continue heating it after I pour it because I'm gonna have a hot tea. But I need 1.5 cups of water. Now we're gonna let her go. Okay, so the yeast is gonna go straight here. I just used the same measuring cup that the milk was in. None of that's a big deal. The milk heated, you can see the steam coming off of it. I just give it a little whisk to make sure we don't curdle, and we let some of that steam start coming off of it. But to this, we're gonna add 6 3/4 teaspoons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and a pinch to grow up. Okay, perfect. So we're gonna let this bloom. It takes about upwards, sometimes about 5 minutes. Give it a little whisk in there. I'll bring you back. Okay, I get a lot of questions about my mixer. It's new. I just got it this month, if you didn't know, and it's a Bosch, B-O-S-C-H. It has the bowls. It has different bowls. Up here, you're able to put things like the food processors and so on. The other thing that this mixer does is it flips on its back, and in this you can attach like some grain mills and some other things. I love it so far, but I haven't had it very long, so I'm not actually giving a review on it until I've used it on quite a few different things, different applications, and then I'll let you know how I feel. So on to the dough. In here, I went ahead and added some honey when you weren't looking. I'm going to go ahead and add the milk. I'm going to give it a quick whisk. We just want to dissolve the honey. So that's nice and warm. We're gonna start adding the eggs. So I do 6 eggs for 3 batches. Right to the eggs and the milk, we're gonna just add the yeast. Okay, from here, we're going to start adding our flour and olive oil, and some salt is the last things we have. So on our flour, it's about 5 cups per batch. So let's just start with 5 cups. 5. So that's batch number 1. I'm going to add the salt, which is about 1 teaspoon per, or about that much. And the EVOO is in tablespoons, and it's about 4 tablespoons each. And I reserve some of it after we've kind of gotten the flour in. I don't know why, and that's not part of the instruction. Thank you. All right, I'm just gonna scrape down. Sides. It's been about 5 minutes, so I am going to. So it actually looks and feels really good. Wow. I'm amazed at how well it kneaded my dough for me. I'm gonna give it just a couple of minutes by hand though. One or two, because I don't want it breaking like that. I'm gonna try and get rid of that myself. The bread is way too big, and this is the biggest bowl I have, but I'm gonna wait until it's like overflowing and punch it down. About 1 hour, 45 minutes, however long it takes. I was stirring the wax, getting ready to start waxing my cheese, and I looked over, you guys, look at this. What in the world? It could not, it's about to blow over. Okay, so we're gonna punch this down. But I'm going to give it a few minutes while I deal with the cheese, and then we're going to cut and divide this, and I'll bring you back for that. Okay, I'm just gonna let the wax melt. So each of the pizza recipes, so you would just divide that by three, would make four cast iron, like a deep dish cast iron pizza. So we're gonna divide this guy into 12 pizzas. So you wanna bring it down, doing like probably a little better punch down job than maybe you normally would. Because from here, all that what we're going to eat for dinner is going to go into the freezer. So let's start. And I'm not gonna weigh these like, but you totally could like get an exact measurement. Let's start with half. And we wanna do six pizzas out of this half. And if you're using a small cast iron pan, like one of the smaller 8 or 10 inch ones, guys, divide this even further. So instead of four pizzas, maybe do six. But if you're using, I use the big cast iron pans for my size family and the age and so on. So you could do even more pizzas out of this. So I need a third. Smells so good. So good. How do you? Okay, I'm just gonna continue this. I'm gonna wrap each one with a little bit of plastic wrap, and that's because if I wrap it with anything else, and believe me, I've tried, if I wrap it with anything else, it blows out because it wants to keep rising, even when I pop it in the freezer, because it's already in that mode. So this is the first rise though. So these are gonna go in the freezer in a Ziploc bag. And But when you go to make the pizza, and I'll leave that in the description box, all the instructions, you're going to let it do one more rise in the cast iron pan. Okay, let's take a look. So, the mozzarella did not dry out, but it's starting to crack nearly as well as the cheddar did. So what we're going to do though, is we're gonna take a clean paper towel and just blot and make sure there's no oil on any of it. And then down here in the crock pot, let me get you guys in here, see what I'm doing instead of just my face. Okay. So in this crock pot, and I did have to turn it up to high on this little crock pot. I am gonna crank it down. I'm gonna try keep warm. And we'll just see how that goes. I do have a brand new clean paintbrush if I feel like I need to paint it on somewhere. And then what everyone I've seen do, look, it's kind of cracky. We're going to dip the cheese in. Pull it out. Look, it's already almost set. We're gonna turn it up. We're gonna let that dry. Next. So we're gonna do two dips on each cheese. Look at that. Perfect. Okay. Just wanna lean. Okay, back to this guy. We're gonna do the second dip this way now. And then a third and a fourth. So it actually is gonna take me four chances on each cheese. But before I put you on time lapse, I wanted to kind of talk you through it a little. Okay. Okay. We're gonna give them just a couple of minutes. I'm gonna do all the rest on time lapse. Okay, I'm going to make the decision to flip the mozzarellas over after I remove these and let them go a little longer. That's how much wax we have left. But I need the outsides of these mozzarellas to be a little bit like closer to this kind of dry than this is still quite wet. But look, they did excellent. So you just make sure there's no, see that little, just seems to be an opportunity for the cheese to peek through. So we're just gonna inspect them. They're already dry, but I'm gonna let these dry completely at room temperature. Yeah, and then I'm gonna label them.
Let me show you.
So I just have these washable candy jar labels for now, but I thought maybe if I wanted to reuse my wax, that would be kind of easier to take off. I did order labels for these because we wanna know what kind of cheese is cheese in there. And that was part of the stuff I didn't get from Amazon. So we're gonna let these guys dry. Then we're going to let the mozzarella dry. I'm going to make pizzas with the pizza crust that we made. So I think we've had a pretty full day. What do you guys think? We went to Anchorage. Anchorage is an hour and a half from me. We went to the eye doctor, made a quick trip through Costco, got some stuff for the kids' emergency kits, got home, made pizza crust, waxed some cheese. I think I'm good. I think I'm done for the day. So thank you, those of you that stuck around all the way to the end. I really do appreciate it. If you haven't yet, would you hit that subscribe button, ring the bell so you get notifications and then you don't miss anything we have going on our homestead. As far as this cheese waxing goes, stay tuned to the channel and I'll keep you updated on how everything as it goes along is doing in the cheese fridge. So also, when you leave comments or thumbs up, those things do help the YouTube algorithm. They help our channel to grow. But I want to hear from you. I want to hear, what did you do today? What are you working on? How has this month been for you? How have you adjusted? Have you stuck with it? Have you done it here and there? How did it go? I want to know. If you're new around here, say hello. I try to say hello back to everyone. So I think that's it. I hope you guys are blessed. I hope you have squirreled some things away and that you feel a little bit more secure of whatever season may be coming next. But until then, I will catch you tomorrow in tomorrow's video. We'll see you soon. I did re-dip the mozzarella just to make sure we weren't growing any bacteria.